In the place of prayer, you receive revelation.
And when that revelation comes,
you begin to do according to the precept that was shown you.
That's what Jesus said. The miracles that you see me get is because I do what I see my Father do. So in the place of prayer, he is receiving revelation for the work. He writes it down and he comes and do what God shows him to do. Faith without work is dead. Glory does not happen. You prepare for glory. So prepare me a habitation. When God anoints you, the anointing will lead you to preparation. Because without preparation, there will be no glorification.
God has commissioned Apostle Claude Azangisa to spread the fire and presence of the Holy Spirit in the heart of every young person, making Christ the ultimate personality in their life. Get set for a word that will set your heart on fire for God and grant you dominion over the affairs of life. Now, Apostle Claude Azangisa.
Hallelujah. So let's sit down. Praise the Lord. Yesterday was powerful, right? Who had a great time yesterday? Ah, come on. I was expecting somebody to be much more excited than that. Who had a great time yesterday? Ah, come on. Ah, no. It's like you guys have refused to learn. Who had a great time yesterday? It's like you guys have refused to learn. Listen, the prophetic atmosphere works with joy. Not only the prophetic atmosphere, the atmosphere for the supernatural. The supernatural has an atmosphere that it works with. It's the atmosphere of joy. Each time the devil wants to destroy your miracle or wants to destroy an event that's supposed to take place, he has to create something around you to remove joy. Because the Bible says it is with joy that you will draw from the wealth of salvation. God is about to create a miracle in your life. So the devil wants to remove the means for that miracle to be activated by attacking your joy. But you know what? Let me tell you something. Make up your mind that your joy is only in Jesus. The only thing that anybody can do to you to disrupt your joy, to take away your peace, is to take away Jesus. So if they take your phone, your joy is not in your phone. So when they take away your phone, your joy is still intact. When they take away your money, your joy is still intact. Because the Bible says we glory in tribulation. Count it all joy when you go through diverse tests. Hallelujah. Amen. Count it. It means in the place of test and trial, be in joy. Because if you lose your joy, you've lost your miracle. And the ultimate way to activate the miraculous in your life is by being joyful always. Practice to be joyful. Practice it. Don't wait for situations to make you joyful. Because joy is not a product of circumstances. Joy is a product of the presence of God in your life that produces circumstances. So as long as God's presence is still intact in my life, nothing else moves me. So take away my money. My joy is not in my money. My peace is not in my money. My joy is in the Lord. The Bible says, rejoice in the Lord always. Don't rejoice in your money. So my joy, I don't have joy when I have money. When money comes into my bank account, I don't have joy. I get happy. When somebody sends me money, I get happy. Happiness and joy are not the same. Happiness is dependent on circumstances that make you happy. Happenings that make you happy. So it is conditional. But joy is unconditional. It is independent of happenings. Whether things are going on well or whether they are not going well, I've learned to be independent. My joy is not in what is happening or in what is not happening. My joy is in the Lord. Hallelujah. So don't let the devil steal your joy. Listen, so many people have gotten weak in their walk with God. You know why? Because their joy is out. When you lose joy in the work of the ministry, when you lose joy in God, you become weak. Because the Bible says the joy of the Lord is what? Now I know why some of you are weak. Because there's no joy. You're so weak to even respond. Listen, Smith Wigglesworth said something. He said, I don't ask Smith's word how he feels. I tell him how he feels. He said that he has one principle. He said when he wakes up in the morning, the first thing he does, before even coughing, the first thing he does is to jump from his bed and begin to dance with no music. My dance is not dependent on any sound. Whether there is a music or there is no music, I've got the presence of God. He says the first thing he does is to dance and to praise God and dance and dance and dance. Because joy creates an atmosphere for the supernatural. So you can have the supernatural every day in your life by joy. If you feel sick in your body, don't start crying. No. In the midst of it, the Bible said, count it all joy when you go through diverse tests. So meaning in the place of tests, learn to laugh. Learn to laugh. Do you know that's how God behaves? The Bible says in the book of Psalm 2, he that sitteth in the heaven shall laugh. Learn to laugh always. The Bible says, rejoice in the Lord always. Again, I say rejoice. He was emphasizing joy. So joy should be an always thing. Always is you make a conscious effort to be joyful. Because that's where the power is. The Bible says, you shall go out with joy. So before you step out of your house, begin to rejoice. When somebody is trying to fight you, you are laughing. They say you're an idiot, you laugh. You say, yes, I knew it. There's a guy in our ministry who is like that. He's difficult to see. You can't get him angry. His name is Precious Wakoma. That guy will live long. Prophet Nimsha taught me something today. He said, do you know that money is a spirit? It is with joy. When you are joyful, money stays around you. But when you put away joy, even when you have money, the money will go away. When you are stressed and tensed, if they put 10,000 in your hand, come the following day, the money will just go. Because there's no atmosphere to keep it. There's a difference between currency and money. What you have is currency, but not money. Because money is the spirit that produces currency. And the spirit that money works with is called joy. So when you have joy, you will always have money. Somebody will just call you out of nowhere. Learn to be joyful. When you come to the house of God, shout. And we say, praise the Lord. And we say, hallelujah. Hey, come on. You rise to your, look for every opportunity to shout. Because the Bible says, God shout. That says, shout unto God. When last did you shout unto God? Now, when last did you shout unto God? The last place where you shouted was at your, hey! The last where you shouted was at your spouse, or at your girl, or at your, yeah, that's the place. That's the place you can shout. But when a movie is being played, ha, ha, ha! Check, when last did you shout unto God? No, ask, be honest, ask yourself, when last did that really shout unto God? We have the miracle to destroy cancer. It's in a shout. Not any shout, but a shout unto God. How do you shout unto God? Glory! I showed you that scripture where it's that in his temple, everybody shout glory. Listen, when you're going through something and it's like everything in your home is upside down, there is a power that brings it. The kingdom of God is righteousness, peace, and joy. I said the strongest of all those three is joy. The most powerful of them all is joy. That is why it is the most difficult to walk in. You can easily walk in righteousness and not in joy. Have you seen righteous people, but they're not joyful? Because joy is the most difficult one. It's the most difficult. Try it. Try and be joyful right now. Try and be joyful. And see. Try it right now. And just begin to laugh. Laugh. Come on, laugh. You see, it's difficult to even bring out your voice to laugh. Some of you are just doing this. You can't laugh. Listen, let me tell you something. It is the power of God that looks weak. It looks foolish, but it's the power of God. Bible says, he that sitteth in the heaven shall laugh. God laugh. You are too big. You are too classic to laugh. Laugh. Nigram. 2 a.m. Wake up. May God transport you into the witchcraft realm. And you see what they do. You will see them. Ha, 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 ha. Yeah! It's a weapon. They understand the weapons of the spirit. They use it. We that it was originated from, we don't use it. The demons, they use it. And they become powerful. Because to access an atmosphere, you need the key of that atmosphere. And joy is a key. You are just there, frowning. Continue frowning. Hold it. Do you know what the Bible says? Listen, let me tell you something. Joy is a... Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. I like that. I like that. I like that. I love that. Give me that atmosphere. Come on. Yes, give me that atmosphere. Come on, come on. Yes. Joy. Praise the Lord. Do you know that joy, it has the capacity to affect natural things? You don't know. That's why I was telling you, money is affected by joy. A man that does not have joy, give him 1 million. He will not know what to do with it. Even if he knows what to do with it, he still will not be satisfied. He will be complaining, this money is nothing. The money is diminishing. Dallas is rubbish. It's a lie. A man that has joy, give him 10,000. He will be fruitful with that money. Because money is a spirit. Money, there's a difference between money and currency. Dallas is currency, money is a spirit. Money works with the atmosphere of joy. When you are joyful, you become content. They give you 5,000. It can satisfy all your needs. With 5,000, you'll be surprised. But a man that has no joy, give him 20,000. He still will be complaining about the economy. They still will be complaining. Listen, joy has a way of affecting your atmosphere, of affecting your life. I said, joy is a spiritual thing that has physical impact. Let me give you an example. The Bible says, a man that is what? Not that, a merry soul, doeth well like medicine, but what? A broken spirit, it dryeth the bones, meaning that the joy that you have, it has impact in your body. If you are sick in your body, the fastest way to get well is to start rejoicing. Listen, there's something in the body. They are called hormones. There are some liquids that are excreted in the body. I don't know what they are called, but I know that there are some liquids in the body. There is a specific liquid in the human body that is only released when joy is activated. And that liquid, it heals the body automatically. It heals faster than medicine. Try it. When I had malaria, I was really sick. I was very sick. Until my friends came around me. When my friends came around me, we started chatting. When we were chatting, I forgot that I was sick. They made me laugh. Chidi, they made me laugh. I forgot I was sick. I walked them home. We were walking home. I was jumping with them. Laughing. But when they left, and I remember that I was sick, all of a sudden, all the symptoms returned. Because joy is the... When I was joyful, those hormones were activated. It was healing instantly. The Bible does not lie. It says, a joyful heart doeth well like medicine. Meaning, a joyful heart is medicinal. A sorrowful one dryeth the bones. Listen, don't give anybody the power and the right over your joy. Don't give any situation the right over your joy. Become the master of your joy. Whatever the person does or does not do, does not determine your joy. You are joyful always, always. Rejoice in the Lord always. Because when the joy of God is taken from your heart, you become an angry person. And when you become angry, you can't focus. You can't think well. Try to prophesy when you are angry. A man who is always happy can always prophesy. Elisha knew the dynamics of the prophetic. That's why he told them, bring me a minister, because I'm angry, I can't prophesy, I need a joyful spirit. Because it is with joy that you withdraw from the world of salvation. The joy of the Lord is your strength. So if you are feeling weak in your body, always joy. People who are not joyful, they're always sick, very sick. Sickly people are always serious. Serious people are always sick. Always serious, with a hard face. How are you?
Fine.
The thing is cool, but they are wearing a demonic atmosphere. The Bible says, he gives beauty for ashes, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness. So many people are wearing spirit of heaviness. There is a spirit. Don't allow any demon give you a spirit of heaviness. Don't allow situations give you a spirit of heaviness. Don't allow anybody give you a spirit of heaviness. Become in charge of your life. When somebody is trying to give you a spirit of heaviness, go to them and hug them and say, I'm stronger than you. I love you. That's why the most powerful weapon in the kingdom is love. The prophetic goes with noise. God is not quiet. He said, praise him with all the instruments. The reason why we don't experience the dimensions of the supernatural in Gambia is because many people don't understand this simple key of joy. Church is not supposed to be like this. Ave Maria. Oh. Of course, there's a place for that. But for the miraculous to happen, is joy. Do you know what the Bible says? It says joy unspeakable. Do you know what is joy unspeakable? When you're just laughing for no reason. You can't even talk, you're just laughing. Full of glory. Jesus was a happy guy. That's why the Pharisees didn't like him. They expected him to be straight like this. But he was free. Hallelujah. When you come to the house of God, learn to free yourself. Be happy. Yes, learn to dance. Every day, dance. Yes, when you get back home, dance. I'll dance. Because you are creating. Now you are not dancing because you feel like it. You are not dancing because you have a consciousness of what you are doing. You are dealing with understanding. Some of your faces are always straight. Even though your name is Freeman, you don't look like you are free. Always like a slave. Always frown. But God has made you free. And has even given you a name, Freeman, to help you. Learn to be joyful. Learn to be joyful. Because it is with joy that you withdraw from the world of salvation. Rejoice. Rejoice in the Lord. Do you know what it means to rejoice in the Lord? It means take pleasure in God. Every day, praise Him. Praise Him. Laugh. Say, God, you are so good. Even though your son is dying, you are holding your dead baby in your hand. You are saying, God, you are so good. Blessed be your name. Somebody say, hey, are you okay? Listen, the Bible says, rejoice in the Lord. When? When do you rejoice? Always. When something good happens. All what? Always. Rejoice in the Lord when? Always. So when you read your exam and they cheat you, they give you 0%, what do you do? Lift it up and say glory! You see, it takes a man who is spiritually strong to do that. A man who is spiritually weak cannot rejoice. A man who is spiritually weak, he needs circumstances to help him. And they're not even rejoicing, they are happy. You need to know when to be happy, when it is happiness, and when it is rejoicing. Just rejoice in the Lord when?
Always.
Again, I say, rejoice. Let your moderation be known unto all men. The Lord is at hand. Be careful for what?
Nothing.
Hey, what does it mean to be careful for nothing? Then don't worry. Tell somebody, don't worry. Come on, tap somebody and say, don't worry. Say, don't worry. Your God is bigger than that. Don't worry. Come on, give. Listen, Listen. Let me listen. It is a deadly price for you to have somebody you don't like. It's a heavy price to pay. For you, for me to have somebody that each time I look at you and my heart cuts. I am not doing it to you, I'm doing it to myself. I'm depriving myself a power. So I make up my mind to love everybody for the sake of my own spirit, because I want to walk in power. So there's nobody I don't like. Offend me. You see, you can't get me to lose my power. I'm too strong for that. I'm stronger than you. Bring the hate, I bring the love. My love is stronger than any hate that you can bring. Bring it on. Let's fight. Let's compete. Bring the hate, I bring the love. Let's see who will stand. I will love you till you run. I will show you how strong I am. My love is stronger than your hatred. Look at me. Roll your eyes up and down. I'll roll it down and up for you. Come on. When somebody offends you, listen to the wisdom of God. The Bible says that your enemies shall go and cook for them rice. That's what the Bible says. It says when you have an enemy, you know what? How you treat your enemy. It's not like this. Woo! My enemy passing! Woo! Woo! They are coming! Woo! The Bible says, when you see an enemy, run to your bank account, write a check, and say, your hair looks so nice. Have this. God bless you. Your enemy will turn around to respect you for life. You know what you've done? You have established a ruler for that enemy. But when that enemy is the one that affects you, it means they have a rule over you. But when you're the one that affect them, it means you rule over them. You affect them with your love. Bring on the hate, I bring on the love. See, if I see somebody who did me wrong, he went and speak bad about me behind my back, and I heard it, I'm like, you are just giving me an opportunity to love you more. So what do? I take you out with ice cream. And I don't say, I'm buying your ice cream to show that I'm bigger than you. Yeah, chop your ice cream. Nah. It's not attitude. It's not attitude, it's love. You go to their house and wash their clothes and hang it well. Somebody say no. Go right over your head. Listen, the Bible says God is the avenger of these things. It's God. When you do these things, when you say let God arise, let his enemy be scattered. Let God, and you look at your enemy, let his enemy be scattered. Let God arise and his enemy be scattered. Let God arise. Let God. How do you let God arise? It says, let God arise. Allow him to arise. How do you let him arise? By identifying his nature. His nature is love. How let God arise is a doing verb. It means let the God in you arise. How does it arise? Through your love. Apostle Alex said something. He said, man of God, if I open the door and I see my wife with another man on the bed. No, I don't need to. We don't need to ask what prince will do. We know what we'll do. We know what will happen. We don't need to ask prince what will happen if you open the door and you even see a man is just not even on the bed, just hugging like this, or just laying hands praying for his wife. That hand, that would be the help. Apostle Alex said, "See, if I open the door and I catch somebody on the bed with my wife, I know you will literally bring out the scripture and say, I'm going to divorce her because the Bible gives us the right. You know what Jesus Christ said? He said, Moses gave you guys that law because of the hardness of your heart. That's why you have to give that law. The Bible said, while we were yet sinners, I'm going to say, if I catch my wife on the bed with somebody, say, I'll close the door. Either I will pick my wife up and take her home and wash her and do as though nothing happened. Listen. Hold on. Let me ask you. Where do you think is the torture? Where is the torture? When you beat her and killed the man, have you changed her? You change her. She won't even feel, maybe if she feels bad, but she will feel like, oh, I paid the price for what I did. He has beaten me, I paid the price, it's okay. But when he did not beat you, he didn't even say a word and just carried you home. And on the road, bought you ice cream and did like nothing happened. Listen, that is the fastest way to kill her. She will die. Listen, I don't know for you, if my wife was to catch me with a woman, another woman, and she comes and tells me, baby, let's go home, and smiles. Please say, if you said go home, you said, don't go home. He said, don't go home. He said, if you tried, you would die. Don't go. Listen. That reaction will even make you afraid. He said, baby, let's go home. You will be afraid. You yourself, you will be afraid. You will start begging. Nobody will tell you. You will, baby, please. You will start begging. Nobody will tell you. Which is more powerful? God's way is more powerful. The Bible says, when you have problems with an enemy, you know what the Bible says you should do? He said, buy them bread. Give them food to eat. He said, doing that, it is heaping a coal of fire on their head. He said, that coal of fire is not something that will kill them. It will become hot. It will melt their heart. That's how God behaves. Listen, do you know who we are? Do you know what it means to be a sinner? And God looks at you and calls you righteous. Imagine that. A sinner like you, he looks at you and says, Prince, you are my righteousness. He didn't only call you righteous. He said, you are as righteous as me. Who could be more powerful than that? But you? Nah, I didn't die today. It's a deadly price to pay to have someone you don't like. If right now you have someone you don't like, make a conscious effort to get them a gift, just so you can free yourself from that energy. So you can free, it's not you freeing them, it's freeing yourself. So that you can be free for God to move through you to that person. Are you hearing me? Can you just smile? Okay, let me read you that story. Rejoice in the Lord, Philippians chapter 4, verse 6. Be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God, and the peace of God. Yeah. This word peace is from the Greek word erene. It means stability. Yes. It means adjustment. Peace is the power of adjustment. Let me explain that to you. When a man carries the peace of God, peace is a condition of stability. It is a power that it is the power of moderation. It moderates things. For example, there are some things in the car, it moderates the engine. There's a moderator in the car. It moderates everything. If that thing is removed, you see the car will go, ah! So there's something that they put, it moderates the sound. Let me give you a better example to help you. Daniel was carrying the peace of God in his heart. When they were throwing him into the lion's den, he was not trying to fight. Don't throw me. He was not trying to fight back. He was peaceful. the lions were not peaceful, because the Bible says those lions were hungry. They were not fed for days. The peace of God is an atmosphere that moderates things. If things were not moderated, when peace comes into play, it moderates things. It adjusted things into moderation. It's a power that keeps things together. Those lions were not moderated. They were out of course looking for who to kill. But when peace stepped into the situation, it brought the lions to its atmosphere. It's an atmosphere of moderation. So if at all a place is everything is scattered, if peace is ignited, everything that went out of course, it comes into course. It moderates everything. It brings everything back to course. That's what peace does. So meaning, if at all you were crying over something that went wrong, when the peace of God hits your heart, when it begins to hit your heart, it will moderate you and moderate the situation. And the peace of God, what does it do? It will garnish in your heart. It will keep your heart. Meaning something happened at home and everything is broken apart. When the peace of God hits your heart, it will fix the situation first in your heart. Then when your heart is fixed, from your heart, it will now flow on the outward. Everything around you become peaceful. But when you don't have peace in your heart, let's just bow your hand and I'm going to pray in the Holy Ghost. Iraba Hasede. Bow your hand and pray in the Holy Ghost. Speak in tongues if you can. Ibala katolo boshede bede bede. I felt like I needed to talk to somebody. That word was for somebody. Bow your head. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Pray in the Spirit. E katalaba. Leka boshede bede. Iba santa katabale. Iba santa katabale.
Dear saints of God, we believe this message has been a blessing to your soul. Please to share your testimony with us, contact us on +220 3199330 or 3064155 or 3321694. You can also send us an email at actofchange1@gmail.com or follow us on Facebook at Act of Change. Act of Change Ministry, changing lives, transforming nations.
All the true worshipers, you don't need no help. Just open your mouth and release that sound that's inside of you. Come on. Release your sound in here.
There's beauty in my brokenness. I've got true love instead of pain. There's freedom, though you captured me. I've got joy instead of mourning.
There's beauty in my brokenness.
I've got true love instead of pain. There's freedom, though you captured me.
I've got joy instead of mourning.
You give me joy
down deep in my soul, down deep in my soul, down deep in my soul.
Yes, you give me joy
down deep in my soul, down deep in my soul. Freedom, though you captured me,
yeah.
I've got joy instead of mourning.
never been more secure knowing you're fire.